You mind? We're trying to look at these chests. Oh, she couldn't even shoot it with her arrow. Oh, he killed it anyway. Punched a squirrel in the face. Can you imagine going around punching squirrels in the face? Imagine squirrels attacking you. So yeah, it attacked me, so I punched it in the face. Seemed like the right thing to do. It was supposed to go this way. These things move a little slower. Let's see, how much experience will it give me? We're okay with hit points and stuff. We're doing a little dance. No, I wanted to hit the other thing. You can't reach that. Ah. That's stupid. A mispress or something. Bears are going down pretty easy. Ouch, they hit hard though. Oh, it's still alive. McBain will finish it off. No, wow. It's probably sitting at like one hit point. Oh, I didn't notice. It seemed to give us a little bit of XP. Just checking around for any chests and try to look in them again. I'll fight this thing. Only two. Still kicking. See how much it goes out. Yeah, it's a small amount still. Not really that worth it. Oh, we just... okay. Whew! Let's take a little rest, McBain says. Forte says, it's exhausting going up and down a hill and fighting tons of monsters. Una says, but a beautiful scenery like this takes any fatigue away. Forte says, Leon must have come here too. I wonder what he thought as he walked past this place. McBain says, he may have been humming the etude he left at the music school. Una says, by the way, don't you write music, Grandpa Mac? Huh? No, I prefer performing music written by others. Forte says, probably I'm a natural performer too, rather than a composer. It must be fun to create music of your own, but what I enjoy more is to perform pieces written by others, by playing them in my own way. No, you're just being lazy. Be creative. Una says, everyone has his strength and preference, right? But listen, Forte, Una. Troubadours must do more than just play music and entertain people. Like? They both say. If we see people in trouble, we must help them. If we see people who are sad, we must make them smile again. It's not always possible. If we see people who are about to make a mistake, we must stop them. If we see people who fight, we must appease them. We must always think about what we can do for those we meet at each place and try to provide them with food for the mind. Playing music is just a means for accomplishing this mission. You say such a cool thing, says Forte. Well, we better get going, says Una. You're so impatient, Una. Why don't you sit down and enjoy the scenery for a while, McBain says. Just say you want to rest more. Is this hill too much for your old bones? Whose old bones? I'm not nearly finished. All right then, says Una. Let's go to the Hilltop Tavern. Cavern. Says McBain. What are you talking about? Things that make you go, Oh, things that make you go, fight. Ooh, one-shotted that thing. Glitched out with the dog. I like when he hits for exactly 100 like that. We're like halfway to level 11. But we gotta go mess with the tuning fork. Here it is. We could rest at the inn, but I don't feel like running up there and running all the way back down here. I don't think it's that far, but I'm not sure, so... So I'm gonna save here, because if we get trashed... This never happened. Wink, wink. So... We can detoxify an ally. We can release an ally from the effect of a spell. And we can identify an invisible enemy. I don't think that's going to be useful, but... And then we have this water splash that McBain can do. And then if we really need it... We have this thing that was expensive. Tarp. Fully restores hit points and magic points and removes negative effects. So, I have one of those. I'd prefer not to use it, but... I'm probably gonna have to use it. So it's a pretty cool feature. Go back and live through scenes from the other two games. Pretty awesome. Yeah, that's what you said when our level was not nearly high enough. Battle on ship. Wish me luck, guys. The Planetos. We kill you! There's another group right there. Alright. It's gonna be Interrupt City here. I wonder if you defeat one group and you come back, will that group still be gone, or will they all, would it respawn, you know, like, there'll be all the groups back again. Well, since we can reach the Matcheteers, everyone attack the Matcheteers. Jan will attack this one, because we probably can't reach the other one. I'm ready for my interrupt. Still kicking. These guys are tough. Nice. One down. Sweet. That's a necromancer, I guess? Oh no, it's the other guy. The blowgun guy. Doggy needs healing. Oh, I should have interrupted. Pero, pero, cure. Pero means dog. Lick, lick. That's the medium one that has a lick, lick. Two licks. No necromancer. Very bad. Ah. I didn't want to waste all the time healing. Hopefully you can take down the necromancer and the matcheteer. Oh! Well, that's right, the dog can use items. Don't ask me how. I think it's, restore snuff, yeah. And it gives him 50 hit points back. Which, of course, if he gets hit, will be automatically killed again, but... Oh, he's still kicking. And so is he. That's not good. Too late to interrupt. I was too late on that. Oh, crap! Wow, we need more cure bottle M's and stuff. Lick, lick. Interrupt. Kill the necromancer. Oh, I don't have any more interrupts. I was instinctively trying to do that. Try to wake up Forte here. We're giving this battle all we have. I can't get in more, like, 5 more battles like this. We'll never make it. All we have left is this one blowgunner. Just kill him. Nice! Haha. Good XP. How do I go back? I want to go back now. Yes. Hold on 1 second. I don't want to bump into them, but... I think there's just one down there. Alright. We defeated one group and got a good amount of experience from it. Oh, when we come back, we have all our stuff back. We're not going to have our interrupts back, and that was what helped us win that battle. That was the cat. That was our cat with us. Our cat had a strange experience with the tuning fork. Excuse me. Fine, why not? After the battle we just had, this is easy. She can reach with the arrow, bow and arrow. So I guess that's a good way to heal up. You just go into the other world and then automatically leave. And then you're at full strength again. Hey! Close to level 11. Well, that's the one that just stands there. Yeah, I want to get to 12. I want to fight that scenario again, but not... I'm going to wait till at least level 13 to do it again. If you hold down the bottom button, I don't know if that's a circle, a square, or what, because I'm using a different joystick. They go fast like that. See? Well, she didn't run that far. Maybe the monster will run faster. This got a... Forte has a full meter already. We're so close to the next level. Actually, technically McBain made that level. Oh, I thought this was the... where the tavern is. Well, at least we don't have to go back. Hopefully, should not have to go this way again. Should be all new stuff after this. Yeah, Yeah, that's how fast it goes. Not so fast, Killer Bear, eh? Oh, crap! You left our dog at one hit point. You cretin. Definitely time for Paro-Paro Cure. I guess that's like cure light wounds, cure medium wounds, or moderate wounds, and then cure... What is it? Light, medium, serious. Cure serious wounds, I guess, is Paro-Paro-Paro Cure. And then we have cure critical. Heal self. That's a lot of hit points back. Forte, level 11, Jan and Rick, and Una, same. There's still... these things still want to fight us. Us run back here twice, these stinkers. No, she's got her arrow, she can reach him. Wow. I don't want to use the charge dog. He's too easy. He didn't even hit us. He's gonna die in a couple hits. Yeah, that would have been a waste to use the finishing move there. Yeah. Getting there! One encounter at a time. Oh, hold the wrong button. There we go. Dupe. Okay, it's too experience. It's not worth fighting them things. Those things. I never talk like that. Them things. Alright, so we know that Bozerl is to the west that way, only 400 milos, so it's pretty close. But of course we're going to stop in the tavern. The old man's not going to be here. He's hanging out back in Cantus. Grandpa Rayzen is coming back as school principal. What? I thought the principal's just going to Riatom Island for, like, a party or a festival or something like that. I guess he's moving to Riatom Island? Yeah. It's only while Principal Forgeon is gone, though. Oh, that's temporary. He's not really the principal. Exchange. Thank you. Anything new? No, we don't find new stuff that often. At least so far. We need a few more Cure Battle M's. I'll get like 3 of them. How about some Leash Bottle S's and Leash Bottle M? Okay. Another copy of Doll Knight 5. Oh, who's this? Oh, Burion! Oh, McBain and children. McBain and children? How have you been? Una says, Mr. Burion, it's a surprise to find you here. Squeak, says Rick. Hello, Desert Rat. Forte says, he wanted to travel with us, so we took him in. I see. That's good. I have some good news for you, Desert Rat. Anessa and Bonessa are taking good care of your friends. Squeak! He's happy, says Forte. Very observant. By the way, why are you here, Mr. Burion? We're heading for the party on Ryotam Island. I left something at the inn we stayed before, and the butler went back to get it for me. What are you doing here? We're on our way to Bozerl. Bozerl, it's a good town. It's pretty developed compared with other places in Graysel. They have delicious bread, too. Oh, sorry, I was sidetracked. I'll wait for my butler, so you go ahead first. Yes, says Una. I hope to see you again. We still have some time. I'll just relax and wait for the butler to come back. Okay. In the meantime, you can pick one of two beds to sleep in. Let's rest. We haven't rested here yet. 40 gen. Good luck with my travels. Oh, thank you. Check this sign again. If they have anything new to say. Oh, nobody hanging out up here, right? Okay. I wouldn't think so. Nothing new. Now, before we call it an episode, before we head this way, and before we call an episode, let's read that Doll Knight 5, shall we? And if nobody cares to hear it, you can tune out now, because that'll be the rest of the episode. Doll Knight Volume 5, The Girl with Sky Blue Eyes. The man in black launched an attack. Rhymes. Pretending to slash diagonally downward from the top right, the man quickly turned his wrist around and slashed at the ribs of the Blue Knight. Having seen through the man's feint, Pedro pulled the threads tightly. The Blue Knight took half a step back to dodge his enemy's blade and disarmed the man with a sharp, jarring blow, leaving him defenseless. How could this be happening? The man in black held his numbed arm with the other, his face turned utterly pale. Deciding that their boss had no chance of winning, the rogues ran away in all directions. Thank you very much. The girl sighed with relief and bowed her head. She was dressed rather nicely and was quite gracious. Pedro figured the girl was a member of a privileged family. Don't mention it. I merely did what any knight would have. Are you from outside the country? Pedro suddenly felt a mischievous urge. My name is Pedro. I am a knight touring from place to place. By the way, this boy is my servant. Oh. So the Blue Knight, quote-unquote, is saying that he's Pedro. But it's Pedro's voice. With ventriloquism. Obviously, the girl hadn't noticed Pedro. She gave him a surprised look. However, Pedro was equally surprised. No, his surprise was several times or even several tens of times greater than the girl's. Did he not say that? The cool turquoise blue eyes and the beautiful face. They were the features Pedro had seen a few times before in festive occasions on the balcony at the palace. Your Highness? The girl in the snow-white dress was Princess Tia, who had just lost her father and was to soon become the new ruler of the country. To be continued. Oh. I notice we can't drop them. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.